I'm Father Columba Stewart, the Executive Director of the Hill Museum and Manuscript Library, and I'm here to share with you one of the volumes of a magnificent set of the first printed version of a glossed Bible. Here you see this magnificent large format book and its original pigskin binding. You can see the fine tooling on the large expanse of the binding to give it a bit of decoration. And then you can see that the book was bound with clasps because such a large book bound with wooden boards was likely to warp and shift unless the contents were held solidly by the clasps. These are very thick wooden boards underneath the pigskin, making it difficult to open the book. It really requires two hands, and it's sometimes difficult to imagine how they actually used books like this. Maybe sitting on a lectern in front of a classroom, because this kind of Bible, surrounded by commentary, would have been the type of text used by a lecturer at the University of Paris or some other great setting where people were eager to learn the details of the biblical text. The volume we have here of a four-volume set contains the prophetic books of the Hebrew Bible. As you see in manuscript versions of a glossed Bible, here too, in printed version, you can see the biblical text with smaller type commentary between the lines, and then on the page, surrounded by longer excerpts from various commentators from the early church in the Middle Ages. This is the prophetic book of Ezekiel, and most of the commentary for this book is taken from Pope St. Gregory the Great, from his famous homilies on Ezekiel. This magnificent book was printed in 1480, and there are disputes about exactly where it was printed. Was it printed in Strasbourg or in Basel? But we know that they had to call in type from a number of printers because it was probably the single largest printing job ever done up until that time. It remains a monument of early printing, the paper itself of high quality, looking like it was made yesterday, the ornamentation added with the rubrics of the red initials and then the red strokes to begin each sentence. All of these hallmarks of the way printing was done in its first decades to make a printed book look as if it were a manuscript.